For my graphics optimization, I will not focus on making the game look as close as possible to the maxed out settings while improving performance a little bit. I want the game to look nice for the smallest overall performance cost. With the GPU I'm using, I'm aiming for 30 FPS and I achieved extremely nice results, but this guide will work just as well for a 60 FPS or any other FPS target. Actually, I didn't even use a graphics card. I used integrated graphics in my Ryzen 8700G. I listed some similar GPUs here, but think this guide is valuable up to any GPUs lower than AMD RX 6700 or so. First, we want to use dynamic resolution upscaling to hit our target. By locking down the frame rate, increasing the graphics settings will lower the render resolution, and it's easy to see whether that goes too low. If Aloy's hair and limbs go all fuzzy and pixelated while running, we set the graphics or FPS target too high. Dynamic resolution FPS target options offered by the game depend on your monitor's refresh rate, and ideally, you choose a target that divides your refresh rate. I analyzed the image quality impact of all major graphics settings to figure out which matter most for a beautiful presentation. I tested all of these settings at 1080p. Some differences are more noticeable at native 4K, so if you're interested in that, I recommend checking out Digital Foundry's video. Texture quality is the first setting in the menu. Here you want to go as high as possible without overdrawing your GPU's video memory. Medium is a huge upgrade over low, while high is visibly better than medium, but not by the same margin. The texture filtering quality is not as impactful as the texture quality setting, but the increase in clarity on the ground texture when going from trilinear to 4x is desirable. Although 8x and 16x still improve the textures, it's not something I chase before dialing in the critical settings. I found the shadow quality on the low setting is sufficient for a nice looking presentation. Although in this comparison there's no difference between very low and low, when I investigated further, I noticed that going from very low to low also affects the distance at which certain shadows are drawn. Here tagged with A2. The shadow details still improve from low to medium 3 and medium to high 4, but the performance cost for shadows is high, so going higher than low is not a priority. Ambient occlusion and screen space shadows are important to visually give the game depth. Ambient occlusion is significantly more impactful than screen space shadows, but they are both fairly cheap in terms of performance, so ideally we'd want both. But in a pinch, I'd sacrifice screen space shadows. Screen space reflections on low help make water surfaces look better. I didn't find any appreciable differences on the high setting, so low is desirable, but again, if you really need a small performance bump, we could turn this off. This isn't cyberpunk. Level of detail affects objects based on the distance from the camera. This is very difficult to present in a handful of images. I've seen it affect different surfaces to different degrees, but very low can make stuff fairly close to the camera blobby, and it may replace distant trees with extremely low res textures. I picked out lots of small differences in this comparison and marked a few, but every increase makes an appreciable difference. So this is the setting I think a good chunk of any excess GPU resources into. When it comes to hair quality, we have to consider that Aloy's hair can be fairly far away from the camera, but it can also be close up when aiming and in cutscenes, and in those scenarios it will take up more screen space, and therefore have a greater performance impact. So quality matters, but we don't want it to negatively affect performance during combat. I found that to medium we see good improvements at a relatively small performance cost, while low already looks decidedly better than very low, and high seems to have a measurable performance cost over medium. Higher levels of terrain quality make the terrain look less flat. We can clearly observe how the ground textures transform into a bumpy surface. Medium is already a huge improvement over low, and high looks almost as nice as very high. So medium and high are my settings of choice here. At 1080p, I couldn't make out a significant difference between low and medium, and high and very high. On the high setting, there seemed to be extra clouds around the mountain tops. In various locations, I was able to notice some differences between low and medium, but saw little performance impact. But low and medium look pretty enough. Depth of field usually has some performance impact, but I didn't analyze it because I like it turned off better, especially if every frame counts. I also recommend turning all screen effects off, but these typically don't affect performance, so consider those preference settings. So here are my optimized settings, quality and performance mode. I recommend you use these settings as a starting point and adjust to your liking and preferences based on the image quality comparisons. In my testing, quality is more performance than built-in high setting, but more demanding than medium. My performance settings result in about 10 to 20% higher frame rate than my quality mode. I hope you liked the video. See you next time.